Please welcome Prasenjit Bose, economist and someone who's been associated in the past with the CPIM till he was expelled by the party. Do join us, Prasenjit. Also joining us is Akhil Ranjan Dutta, professor at Guwahati University, someone who's been part of the political science department there. And he joins us. And also joining us is Moinul Hassan, former Rajya Sabha Member of Parliament of the CPIM. Ladies and gentlemen, please wake up and give them all a very big hand. Good. The simple question that we will be posing to them is, has the left been left behind? Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me. Let's get straight to that question. Prasenjit, would I be right in saying that the left today in Bengal is a dinosaur? And never before in the history of Indian politics has a party gone from being the unquestioned supreme party of a state to becoming a party that today is almost dead as a dodo. This is an extinct party. Would I be right in saying that or not?
Yes, certainly to an extent, because I think that the steep fall of the CPIM from a party which was in power till 2011 to the, I think in assembly today they are in the third position following the 2016 assembly elections, I think is a remarkable, you know, decline, and which is, it's difficult to find parallels anywhere in the country. And I'll compare it with the kind of collapse that we witnessed in Soviet Union or in Eastern Europe in the, you know, late 1980s, early 1990s. And the reason for those are complex, but just let me summarize one or two which I think are most important. I think that the left has suffered, the CPIM-led left front, you know, has suffered from basically two critical problems. Number one is that it has not been able to adapt itself to a world situation which has changed very drastically over the past 25, 30 years. In many ways, it's not only on economic policy, it's about how they view society, how they view culture and so on and so forth, you know, how they view questions of gender, caste, and so the non-class questions and so on. So that has been one problem. I think there has been a kind of ideological ossification of the left in one sense. The other is that they wanted to compensate it by, rather than innovating within themselves, they wanted to imitate what many other political parties were doing in our country, and that was sort of epitomized by the kind of aggressive industrialization drive that happened under Mr. Buddhadev Bhattacharya, where peasants' lands were, you know, sought to be taken away by using force, which gave the opposition an opportunity to actually take the constituency of the farmers, which were the most important constituency of the left, away from the left.
So you're going to blame Buddhadev Bhattacharya. You believe that Buddhadev Bhattacharya, the man who led the left to a three-fourths victory in this very state in 2006, subsequently was responsible for the demise of the left by going in for aggressive industrialization. That's what you're suggesting.
Absolutely. I think that there was this feeling. I'm not blaming him as an individual. I am blaming his vision, his policies. Because I think that there was this understanding that in West Bengal, the Communist Party can do what the Communist Party is doing in China. I think that the biggest problem is that China is a single party rule, whereas West Bengal is a democracy. And in a democracy, you have to reconcile the interests of various classes. You have to look after everybody. The left lost the support of the poor. I think that this is the biggest problem with the left.
Let Moinul take that. Has the left, the biggest change that has taken place, which Prasenjit seems to be indicating, is the left has lost the support of the poor. Today, the poor are with Mamta, not with you. You were the party of the poor, and the poor have deserted you.
Well, it is an undeniable fact that in the last election, and that last election, 2011, CPIM and the left entire lost the support of the common people and poor people of the state. But it is not a fact that Mr. Buddhadev Bhattacharya and other ministers or somebody one is very much responsible for that. One thing I must say, there is a big difference between China and West Bengal.
Mm-hmm.
Big difference between China and West Bengal that Prasenjit has told. Because China has covered up and done their revolution. And West Bengal is merely state. We have taken industrial decision, industrial policy. That policy for the job opportunity, we are in a changeable situation. We are trying our best to open the opportunity of job to the younger section of the people. It may be there is some problem, it may be there is some misunderstanding.
No, it can't just be a misunderstanding. There must be something more. Why is it now, and now we are seeing it over, it wasn't one election. Had the left declined in one election, I can understand. But now it is election after election that the left is losing in Bengal. I'll come back to the rest of the country.
No, in Bengal,
Mr. Something, it cannot be described only as a misunderstanding. I'll come to you. I just want to get one view also from Akhil Ranjan Dutta. Akhil, is it a misunderstanding? Or is there the fact that the left became simply too regimented, too doctrinaire, believed in its own invincibility, and thereby thought that nothing can touch them? We can do what we want in Bengal and no one will touch us. Along comes Mamta and takes away the left's vote.
Thank you, Rajadev. Because I'm an academic and I'll be trying to give some conceptual understanding of it. My first opinion is this, that left in West Bengal has refused to understand the growing, changing dynamics of politics in the state, politics in the country, and politics at the international level. Politics is not only about mobilization. Politics is also about negotiating at different levels. You have to negotiate with the aspirations of the new generation. You have to negotiate with the peasantry. You have to negotiate with the working class. You have to negotiate with the student community. Despite the fact that you have an organized army, organized cadres, but you have not tried, or you have not tried your level best to negotiate with all these forces who otherwise could have been or had been always with you. Remember, when this Singhu incident was taking place, none other than Madhav Patka came and sat with Mamata Banerjee. And this is a very interesting thing, because what Madhav Patka has been talking about is the ideal, or are the issues that left has always been talking about. Therefore, my understanding is that negotiation, constant negotiation, or comprehensive negotiation at different levels. There had been many sympathizers of the left parties who were not party members, but who had always the sympathy with the left government and left parties because of the, you know, because of the initiatives being undertaken by them. But when the single incident happened, many, many left intellectuals, non-party named left intellectuals, had also come on the street to condemn the government. I come from Assam, and I pursue left ideology, but I was also one among them who condemned this Singhu incident, condemning that government is not understanding the aspirations of the people. Government is not in a position to negotiate with the growing aspirations of the people.
No, but why did that happen? Was there a disconnect? Was there a disconnect, Prasenjit, between the ruling leadership and the peasantry? I mean, you've ruled a state for 30 years. Surely you knew what the aspirations of the people were. Did the left get disconnected with the masses? A cadre-based party gets disconnected with the masses? That's what puzzles me.
Yeah, I think that it certainly happens. I mean, had it not been the case, then we would not have had the fall of the Soviet Union, actually. I think that a very long stint in power in a democracy actually blunts your instincts. It complacency sets in, and what in, if you pardon my using that old left jargon, but I would say that there are deviations which creep in the sense that the generation which made sacrifices, which brought the left to power, goes away, a new generation comes in. Along with that comes in a lot of elements who are there just with the left, just because the left is in power. So they are not ideologically committed and so on. So you actually start replicating at the grassroots level what, say, the Trinamool Congress is today, or many other non-left parties in our country are today. Whereas you wear a facade of the left at the, you know, at the top.
No, so did they get ideologically corrupted or morally corrupted or both?
I would say to an extent both. There were instances of corruption, there were instances of wrong. You see, even the Rajarhat land allocation was nullified by the High Court. So it was not only the Singura Nandigram. Generally, the left was the moral capital which the left had. So, because of the struggle of the 60s and the 70s, which they obviously, you know, they gained out of it. Because don't forget that the left was also, it should be remembered, the left in Bengal for being the party which was in power for the largest 10 years. I mean, no other party has been able to rule a state for 34 years. But I think that has ultimately turned out to be its nemesis.
No, but I'm just trying to understand, is Mamata Banerjee the new left? Sometimes when you talk to Mamata Banerjee, she seems more left than the left ever was. And she's replicating your model at the grassroots level, building up her own cadres. She's taking over the CPM cadres who are shifting to her. I'm just trying to understand, to rule India, you cannot be a suit boot ki sarkar. You cannot win elections by winning the vote here in the Oberoi Grand. Even Prime Minister Modi has realized that. Prime Minister Modi has consciously shifted from a suit boot ki sarkar to what he says a garibo ki sarkar. Has the left was the original garibo ki sarkar in Bengal. What, in a sense, did you lose touch with your cadres? Did you lose touch,
Rajdeep,
with the poor?
Absolutely not. One thing I must clear first. There is one question already came that I would like to clarify the situation. That is a Singur case. Singur case that you have told, Mr. I have told that before Singur or before Nandigram. Nandigram is not a case happened, but Singur happened. Before that, lakhs of acre land already acquired before Singur in Bengal. In Bengal, mind it. In Bengal, before Singur, Prasenjit knows, lakhs of acre land acquired by the government of West Bengal, and there is no problem at all. And industrialization has taken place by the policy of Buddhadev Bhattacharya or Mr. Jyoti Bose. Number one. Number two, that your question that we have told this just now, the left is alienated or isolated from the poor. That position is now covered by Mamata Banerjee. I am not talking about Mamata Banerjee. I am talking about the left.
No. Has Mamata Banerjee taken your core vote? She has taken your core vote. Mamata Banerjee has not come to Bengal by capturing some anti-left vote. She took the pro-left made it her own.
Rajdeep, I am coming to the point. I am not talking about her. I am talking that left, all time left are trying to associate it with the common and poor people. Poor people without any jargon, without any show, and without anything else. But it is a fact, the lakhs of people, common people, they isolated or depart from the left politics.
No, so
it is a challenge before the left.
Okay,
it's
so no, I want to understand.
Come back.
Okay,
it is a challenge
see,
before the left.
I think that this
I
is,
am not
this is,
denying that it is the challenge before the left
bring
the common people in the flag of the left.
Why did it happen?
I'm trying to understand why. See, I think that Moinul, I have a lot of great personal regards for him, but I think that he is just demonstrating in a simple way what is precisely wrong with the left. Here is a party which went out of power in 2011. This is, you know, we're on the, you know, in 2011 they lost.
Yes.
Then they lost once again in 2016. This is 2018. Still they are saying that actually koi problem nahi tha. And they will not understand the simple fact that, you know, there may have been land acquisition before that. You answer me a simple question. Land acquisition in our country was happening under 1894 legislation, a colonial act.
Mm-hmm.
It was changed because, not because of the left. It was changed because a non-left politician carried out an agitation. Another non-left government at the center, at the Congress party,
took initiative, and the UPA passed a legislation which today actually are things which I think the left should have demanded, and the left has been demanding, but they did not implement in their own state. And even after losing that election in 2011, the left continues to officially, you ask Moinul, I'm sure personally he will agree with you, but officially they will say, no, no, there was no problem with our land acquisition policy. I think this is the problem with the left, that even when they realize where the mistake has happened, they will not never accept. What, you know, they will dissolve themselves like they know what happened in the Soviet Union, but they will not simply accept that, okay, people, learning from the people, that, okay, people have said we made a mistake, we learn from the people, we accept it in a democracy, and we move on. They will never do that. They will continue to defy the mandate of the people, defy it again and again and again, till they go into oblivion. I think this is precisely what has happened with the left.
One thing, the land acquisition made by the land of the law, it was a central law, you know. Central law. It is not correct, I am telling you, Prasenjit knows better, it was not correct. When this question came, it will be changed. And in the parliament, one draft was circulated. I first go to Prasenjit and tell that, please tell what will happen. It is a fact. Prasenjit, that tale, it is a fact. We learn from the people. Again, we go to the people. This is the idea, not only idea, it is the ideology of the left at present in Bengal also, throughout the country, throughout the globe, they go to the people.
No, you keep saying you go to the people, but the people seem to be rejecting you. And I'm trying to understand something interesting that is happening. What is happening at some level, Akhil, is that in Kerala, on the other hand, the left has come back strongly with a new leader in Pinrai Vijayan, who in a sense is also aggressively industrializing, is claiming that he is building an open economy, and is almost a single party leader in a manner. You're seeing a leader who's, you know, a towering personality within the Kerala left. You've had Manik Sarkar in Tripura. It's only in Bengal, for some reason, that the left seems to be falling behind. It's very much there in Kerala, probably will win Tripura next year. Why is it that it's only in Bengal that the left has lost out of its three states? That's what I want to ask you, Akhil.
I don't think that I'm the right person in presence of these two prominent person from the state to speak on West Bengal. But as I have said earlier, that negotiation, you have to constantly negotiate with the changing environment.
No, what do you mean by negotiate?
I'm telling you.
With the young? Many believe that the left has lost touch with the young.
If there's a perception that keeping the people poor in the name of equity is the ideology of the left, new generation is not going to accept that ideology. I'm telling you what is happening in China. You have because mentioned China. What is the Chinese philosophy now? To be rich is glorious. To be rich is glorious. Even if you look at Tripura, for example, you know, if you look at the secretariat building, the way the secretariat building is coming up, it at least indicates the fact that the Tripura CPM government is trying to negotiate with the changing perception and aspirations of the new generation, coming up with a huge, sophisticated building. As far as West Bengal is concerned, yes, they're talking about industrialization. They have to talking about industrialization. But while doing that, they have to also negotiate with the common and poor people. He mentioned about the land acquisition bill, Land Acquisition Act of 1894. But this Land Acquisition Act has been confronted by a series of popular movements in the country.
So you're saying left should have aligned itself to those movements.
Exactly.
So today when there are farmer suicides in the country,
yes,
the left should have been at the forefront of aligning
exactly
with those farmer movements.
I'll go to the extent of telling left should have been in a position to negotiate with the or ally with the gender movements, transgender movements, ecological movements, farmers movements, fishing communities movement. If left is in the perception that because they have an organized force, because they have their party cadres, they will win the election, I think that is fooling themselves. They have to negotiate with all these forces who are constantly aspiring and constantly confronting with the state atrocities.
So has Bengal changed, Prasenjit? Or did the left, as we said earlier, particularly in the Buddhadev period, change in a manner where the voters felt disconnected? Or was it just the inevitable Bengali fatigue? The Bengali said, yeah, we've tried them for 30 years. It's time to give someone else a chance.
Well, probably it was a combination of everything. You know, I mean, all the points that you said have grains of truth in them. But I think that if you, you know, look ahead, what should the left be doing? Because I strongly believe that neither is the left ideology, you know, irrelevant in a society which is so unequal, where there is so much of poverty and unemployment, and you know, there has to be a party or a force which represents the interests of the poor in the rural or the urban areas.
So Mamata represents that in Bengal
today. No, Mamata, let us, since it's not a session on her, look at how she is responding to the dengue crisis in the state. I can tell you, going by mainstream media reports, over 200 people have died. We have filed a PIL in the High Court. Our government is saying that only, 45 people have died so far. And they are not giving data to the central government. They're suppressing data. Even in rural areas, people are dying. Mamata Banerjee's, whatever leftism, Mahamati Manushi's, is a complete facade. The unfortunate part is the left, you know, they allowed this situation. I mean, even a fake left was seen to be more preferable than whatever the left.
So what should the left do then?
I think that, you know, first of all, this entire baggage of the past, the left should get rid of. I think that's very, very important. This whole defending whatever happened in the Soviet Union, defending whatever happened, all the 34 years, whatever we did was correct. No, you accept that there were some mistakes. Learn from the people. I think the left needs to be more democratic. That is very, very important. Accept your mistakes, move on. Secondly, you know, the most important point, I think, where a lot of rethink is required, is that this whole, you know, Bengal has changed, definitely. How has it changed? I mean, you look at the employment situation, for instance. What is happening in the state? Nothing in terms of industrialization. Mamata Banerjee has actually failed completely. What can be an agenda which can galvanize the youth, say, on the base of employment? Look at the state of education. Look at the state of healthcare in West Bengal. It's in shambles. Even the public institutions are in shambles. What is a vision which can, you know, revamp these institutions, provide a more, you know, affordable, accessible healthcare system, education system? You have to be alive to, you know, the entire caste problem. I think the Bengali left have been completely hypocritical. Whereas the scheduled caste population in Bengal have solidly backed the left electorally till, say, 2006, definitely. But, you know, there is not even a recognition of the fact that there's a huge, after Punjab, Bengal has the highest proportion of scheduled caste population. The left in Bengal, the mainstream left will, you know.
No, so you're calling for more organized protests when the healthcare system is seen to be in shambles. You're calling for organized protests against the decline in public.
And with a vision. And you see, the state secretary of West Bengal, he himself was the health minister. So a lot of problems would be rooted back to then. What happens is, if you give this explanation to the people, no, everything was all right when I was health minister. It's only after Mamata Banerjee came that things have worsened. That's not, people will accept that.
Which is the same problem in a way that the Congress party faces at the center.
Yes, yes, yes.
Today, when the Congress, yes, if it ever points a finger at Mr. Modi on corruption, if they say the Rafael defense deal needs to be examined, four fingers will be pointed at the Congress.
So I'm
just wondering, is there an acceptance, Mr. Huck, of the mistakes of the left? Has the left accepted that this whole notion of democracy, that the left, far from being democratic, became doctrinaire, regimented, became a cabal almost of a few individuals who ran the party in Bengal? Is there an acceptance of that or not?
No.
Is there a recognition that in the name of democracy, you are not a democratic party at all?
No, no. Left parties are the very much democratic party. Number one, I am telling one thing to Mr. Dutta. That is, he told two times that it is the negotiation with the different cross-section of the people.
Yes.
But it is a very good point. I am very much grateful to him. Left parties, particularly my parties, the Communist Party of India, Marxist, we are always trying our best to discuss with the common people. Basically, we are trying our best to discuss with the younger section. That is, Prasenjit told, I am telling that India is a youthful country, you know. Most of the people and ages is under 50.
Why are the young, that same youthful demographic is the one that is most attracted today to Narendra Modi and not to the left?
Yes,
why?
Not to the left, this is the problem.
Why?
Why? Why? And you are telling that what is to be done, you have told.
No, I'm asking you first why you...
Why?
You know,
it is a fact that the young leadership among the left is now reducing. It is not in the proper... I am telling this word now, now not reducing, not up to the mark.
You didn't give the young a chance. Your entire party was based on septuagenarians and octogenarians.
No. We are giving the chance to our younger section to be a leader in the party.
Name me three young mass leaders, a party which ran a state for 30 years. Hmm. Name me three young leaders that you have thrown up.
Those who are 30 years in the party, not young.
Where are the young leaders of the left? Please tell me who are the young leaders of the left in Bengal.
I am not talking any name. Why are you telling?
I have to ask you. What is your definition of young? I sometimes wonder. I see.
You tell me what is the definition of the young.
No, I see your central.
In which age? You telling?
There is still Biman Bose.
No.
There is still Biman
Bose. Biman Bose is a separate thing.
Buddhadev still goes to the. I've gone to your the headquarters here. Hmm. You still seem to have the old geriatric leadership taking decisions. Where is the young leadership?
No. There's a lot of young leader among our party and the left party. There is no dearth of young leader among the party.
Sir, I'm asking you.
You didn't mention the names.
I am not in a position to take any particular name. But you know them.
That is the strategic mistake. If this young generation sitting here ask a leader from the Communist Party of India, Marxist, tell me two names of two leaders who are from the young community, and if the leader refuses, no, I cannot tell the name. That is the perception which goes to the people and thinks that they are not giving importance to the younger generation.
Bookish.
I'm not blaming. Remember, I am a left ideologue.
It is a bookish.
I'm a left ideologue. I'm telling you. Yes. I'm a left ideologue. I'm fighting against the fascist forces. But what I'm telling it...
practical knowledge.
No, that is the problem. When you say that you don't have a practical knowledge and younger generation... That is the problem with the left parties here in West Bengal. You know, you have to... When I say the negotiate, there is a base and superstructure debate. In the communist ideology, you have the base and superstructure debate. And if you continue to talk about only the base, foundation, economy, and if you do not look at the superstructure, what media is talking about, what cultural figures are talking about, what actors are talking about, you are not really negotiating both with the base and the superstructure. I think that is the strategic blunder and strategic mistake which has brought defeat for the left parties, despite being the most pro-poor party in the country.
In a way, I'm sorry to bring in Mamta again, but look at what she has done intelligently with culture. She has embraced all Bengal's cultural icons and adopted. In Bengal, she's not going to allow the BJP to capture Netaji, Swami Vivekanand, Tagore. They are her icons. In a sense, the left failed to do that. The left destroyed culture in this state in many ways. The left destroyed sports, destroyed culture. You didn't celebrate culture.
Absolutely wrong.
You should have celebrated. Mamta has been clever in that regard.
No. That Mamta is doing the hard job, but
her populist politics.
Rasdeep, you have told the left destroyed the culture of Bengal is very objectionable. I am not agreeing with you.
No, it's objectionable.
Why?
But you found...
Left is the... Left to this Adhar Hai culture rakhne ke liye.
No,
left to protect the culture of Bengal forever. Why not?
Sir.
Well, I mean, Rajiv,
telling the left destruct the culture.
Let me put it in this way. I think that, there was a point of time when I would say that if you, consider the left in culturally speaking, it's not only about party. If you look at, broadly in terms of culture, if you look at, the best film directors that Bengal produced, the best artists, the best playwrights, and so on, I mean, almost 90% would belong to some variety or the other of the left. I think that...
As individuals. No. I'm saying as a political
group. If you look at it objectively, what happened was... You see,
a long stint in power, as I was trying to explain earlier, what it did was that there was this what has in popular term nowadays is called dolotantra. You know, it's a particracy. So, you know, it doesn't matter whether a person is a good actor or a good writer. It matters whether that person has allegiance towards my political party. Or same with academics, same everywhere. I think that had been a problem with the CPM, with the left, and they have suffered because of it. It has become a pool of mediocrity. And I would not agree with the fact that it is only about the youth. It is much more than that. The problem with the left today is that the left, at one point of time, the left used to attract the most intelligent people of Bengal. Today, the left is basically left with a huge ocean of mediocrity. I think that is a very big problem. They are unable to, you know, throw up bright ideas. They are unable to, you know, reinvent and innovate, and somehow clinging on to, you know, what they consider to be a glorious past. I think that they should break away from that.
We just have a couple of more minutes. I want to try and understand if there is one thing that you would like to see happen in the next 10 years to the left in Bengal. What would that be, Mr. Haq? What is the one thing? If there was one dream that you have for the left, do you have a dream, a vision for the left, or are you all without a vision today? What is the vision that you have for the left? If there is one thing that you would like to see to spark off this revival, very quickly.
One thing, only one thing. It is not for the Bengal, it is for the left entire globe. Left should relook theoretical and ideological premises.
Relook at its ideological.
Relook.
Okay. Is the problem
that theoretical and ideological premises.
Okay. Enough. Akhil, is the problem with the left ideology or is it simply...
I am not like that. I am not discussing.
Has the left...
Relook and change... You know the difference of the word.
Yes,
relook.
You know, I'd like to explain this by referring to what Cuba has been doing even after the collapse of the Cold War or collapse of erstwhile USSR. I have at least read Fidel Castro's biography very comprehensively and very seriously. What I have understood from Fidel Castro's experiment with Cuba is this, that at every moment you have to revisit your ideology, you have to revisit your strategies. The globe is moving, the country is moving, you cannot be very static. That is the very important thing that we need to know. As far as the political left political parties in India is concerned, I think that these left parties are the best alternative to the kind of government and kind of political parties who are ruling the country today. That, you know, controlling what kind of food you will eat, do you have the right to express, right to expression, and so on and so forth. So left party could be the best alternatives. But when he says that they have to revisit the ideology, I think they have to do it in a very organic manner. They have to do it in a very organic manner in the sense that they have to look at the aspirations of the people. As I have started with telling that base and superstructure both are very important. Culture is very important. Even if we think that it is the base which will determine culture, if you look at Lenin or for that matter Mao, they were trying to negotiate with all these dimensions. But my understanding is this, that sometimes left becomes very, very parochial and they become very, very confined to themselves. And I'm trying to give a statement that today RSS become more leftist than the leftist. What the RSS is doing, RSS will go even to the left political parties to convince that you have to adopt this ideology. That flexibility has to be there, that you have to approach everyone. If you know that this particular person is not following left ideology, therefore I'll not talk to him, that will not help. You have to talk to everyone. You have to convince everyone. Then only you can convince the entire community that left is the alternative to BJP, left is the alternative to the Congress.
Okay. I have just 30 seconds, and I sometimes wonder whether the left is now facing the problem where there are new leaders who are actually left. Arvind Kejriwal would call himself left. Mamata Banerjee would certainly fall within the broad rubric of the left. The belief that you are a party of the poor, the party of the Aam Aadmi. Is it simply today that yes, you have new parties who have replaced an old left. And unless you become a new left, you will be left behind in
Bengal. I completely agree with what you are saying. And I think that the direction in which it needs to move is that you need to have more women. You need web. You go to Alimuddin Street, where is a woman leader?
Right. So not just youth, you need more women. Name me three women leaders at the left of Bengal.
From Bengal. And very difficult. You need to have more representation from the Dalits, from the Adivasis, from the Muslim community within your leadership. I think that that is the... And of course, youth among all of those sections. I think that is the direction in which the left...
Let's give them one credit though. Out of all the leaders of this state, perhaps those, with a few exceptions, who have broadly been relatively financially honest, are still the left leaders. Broadly. I think you have to give them that. I think we sometimes tend to be too harsh on them. And in that sense, Akhil made a good point that the RSS in some respects is a bit like the left. You meet the old RSS in particular, they still seem untouched by the power of money. Let's leave it there. Let's hope that the left comes at least in Bengal as a strong opposition, because that's the least that one would expect in a state which you have ruled for so long. Akhil, we've run out of time, I'm afraid. Thank you very much, Akhil, Ranjan Dutta, Prasenjit both, and Moinul Haq. Thank you very much. Moinul Hassan, thank you very much for joining us on the program. Please give them a very big hand.